We shall now work on the new customer module. The administrator will log into and he will be able to add a new customer. This is our first module that we are working for the administrator. It will be his home page also, so that as soon as he logs in, he lands on this page. We are already following this book, so let us first of all see what we have covered so far. We began with the project, prepared the project, layout file, CSS file, entities. Then we covered Facebook login. Then we went through authorization filters, admin area, navigation menu, helpers for messages, and now it's time to add a new customer module. What will our objective be? Our objective will be to display a screen like this. The menu will come from the partial view that we added yesterday. Customer ID, which will typically be his email, name, phone, cancel button and save button. This is what our target is today in this module. For this, we'll be creating a customer form template first of all. Template will be required because not only data entry has to be made for a customer, his data could be edited also. So the same form will be taken for editing also and for creating a new customer also. It is a very good candidate for templatizing. Then we'll be adding the home controller, which we haven't yet added, and the index view and the HTTP post that will ultimately save the data to the database. We'll see the validations work as we go, because most of the things have already been wired by us till now. If you remember this TBL users MD classes, that wiring has already been done. Now it's time to see it going. So let us start with the customer form template right now. We left the story here. We were adding a message box like thing here. We'll close this partial page for message, for menu. I'll do one thing, I'll close all these pages one by one. Click. This is our solution explorer. This is our admin area. And this is our views folder. We'll add a folder called home here and add a template for the data entry form for the customer. Add folder. I'm doing it the hard way right now. We could have first of all added a controller for home and it would have automatically been there. And inside the home, we'll add another folder called editor templates. As you already know, this name is hard coded. It is plural and editor templates. To this, we have to begin adding our customer data entry form. It is better to take this to the shared one because it will be common across the project. So I'm dragging it. This editor templates, it comes under the shared folder, so it will be common used from I think one or more controllers later on. And in case it is not common, we'll bring it back also. So we'll add a partial page here. Right click, add giving any relevant name, customer form, click OK, and an empty CSHTML page is created for us. We'll start to type things here. So we'll start typing the form. The model TBL user, begin form, then you have a table and adding customer ID. This is the input box for the customer email, and then I'll scroll it. Validation message has also been added. Then for the name TDTR, then it's validation message, phone, validation message, and then you have we have done this JavaScript history dot back minus one for the cancel. So this is a bit of a hack here. Cancel button will be operated by this minus one. It's a JavaScript story here. Submit value, save, and finally we have also added a partial for that message. In case viewback contains something, it will be reflected here. So this is basically the form that we have actually typed here. Now we have to go to our home and controllers. We'll add a controller that will carry this form in it. Right click, add controller, home controller, and simultaneously right click anywhere to add a view also. Keep its name index, and this is the view that has been created for us. Basically we have to put the form into this one. We can side by side put your authorization. Remember that authorization has to be checked for the entire functions of this class. So I'll put the filter that we created earlier here. It will ask for resolve. So this is a very important thing. So each of the actions in this class will go through the authorization filter, and in case it fails, the user will be thrown back to the first page or the login page or the front page of your website, the root. We can have a look at the filter here we added. In case this one, this takes to the root. Okay, coming to fill the form here. So here we start. This will present the menu. Now you can appreciate how this modular view layout design helps us. The menu will be fitted into this one, and a section for the partition, create customer h2 followed by customer form. So this is what a two or three lines, and the entire form is ready. Customer form will come from your template, this one, and ADM and menu will also come from a partial page that we created yesterday. this one. So this will appear at the top. Now let us run and see whether things work so far. When we run it, we encounter this error: multiple types were found that match the controller name home. This is probably because we have home controller in the areas also and outside also. So we have to go and modify our map route and use the parameter that takes namespace parameter. So we have to put our namespace into that. Let us do so. So map route, and there is a namespaces parameter there. So this is our map route, this one. We find a named parameter called name URL, and possibly you have a parameter called namespaces. So this is expecting a this is expecting the namespace of the home controller that we are talking in the defaults. Let us type that. It is IVM project dot controllers. This is the name of your project, and fold it back, and this is the home controller, and this is the namespace that we need to specify. So this is one of the arguments that is available. If you don't have any clashing controllers, then you don't need this one. Let us run it now. It runs. Click login. It goes to Facebook as usual and comes back also. The form is there. And the menu is also there. This is working. And this also proves that our filter is also working, the authorization filter. Now we should check whether our annotations are working. Click on save. They are not working. Clicking here, and it is doing a post back. This means something is wrong. Now right click and view source. If I see view source, the doc type HTML, those had CSS files, jQuery files, they haven't been included here. I can't see them in this list. So what I have to do is, I have to go back and specify the view start file, because we are inside the ADMN area. And it has its own set of controllers, views and all. It also ought to have its own view start file. Now we'll create a view start file and tell where is the layout page for this one. What we'll do is, we'll keep the layout the same as the one for the outer one. For simplicity, otherwise you can change it also. Coming back, this is the areas folder, and this is folded. There is no view start file. Right click, add partial page underscore view start. Click OK. Why I am using this partial page? Because it adds a empty CSHTML file where I can type anything which I want. So nothing special that it is, that it has to be your partial page. It just adds an empty page for us. I'll come to the outer view start, copy this story and paste it here. Save it. close it and now run it. Now we'll run it and see what is the output. Shadow, whenever you receive this type of error, shadow copy, it's always better to build and rebuild it. And then run it. Okay, clicking now. If you see one thing, this has now shifted to the right. This means our layout page should have been accommodated. Yes, it is so. So this thing is settled now. Let us click on save. It is still posting back. Now this is a very serious error which we have to debug it right now. Our annotations are not working. So let us come back to our entity models and check. Double click this one. Anything you see here? This namespace and this namespace, they tally. So this is not the problem. TBL user MD and TBL user MD, it is also okay, but I see one issue here. This should have been TBL user and not an, because this is a partial class for this TBL user. So let us now run it and see. Again, build, rebuild. Now we can click it and now we'll try to use it, and it is done. Now in our next lecture we shall do the actual saving process by clicking it and posting it back. We'll create a receiver to receive the post request. We'll close it right now. Thanks.